everyone. So I am back with a new video, and I actually had a major filming fail this morning. I had all intentions of filming what I eat in a day for today, but I don't know what happened. I was thinking about it while I was preparing my breakfast, and then I must have been very hungry that I ate everything, and then only after I was done, I was like, crap, I didn't film my breakfast. So I'm gonna have to postpone my video for maybe next week. I apologize for all of you who keep requesting those videos, but you know, just know that they're coming. You know, once in a while, I will film what I eat in a day videos, but I do have other videos to share. And I just thought maybe, you know, since I forgot about that video and I wasn't able to film it, maybe let's do something related. And I've been getting a ton of requests to film, and I've been getting these requests for a while too. For all of you who are interested in going into nutrition, you wanted me to film how to become a registered dietitian. So this is going to be the video, and I'm going to have my phone with me because I'm going to try not to forget anything. It is quite of a lengthy process, so I will leave also links below numbered by steps, because I would just make this video a 30-minute video if I went through every single step, but I will sum up the steps and then you can look at the links. These are all links that I looked at when I was researching the schools and like all the systems and just researching for myself. Okay, so the first step in becoming a registered dietitian is to get your degree. So you want to get a Bachelor of Science in Nutrition and Dietetics. Now, it's going to be a little bit different if you're coming from a different background. If you already have your own bachelor's in something, it's not going to take you as long to complete your degree, but it might take a little bit longer than what you might expect. I've had people in my class that were already, they were teachers and they already had their, you know, own profession, and they decided to go back to school to become a registered dietitian, and they still needed to do at least 2 years of schooling. And the reason for that is because not only are you doing your basic classes, but you also have a lot of science. So you take so much chemistry, so many science classes and nutrition related classes, that even if you're coming from a bachelor's in something, you still need to get those as a requirement. So you're still looking at a 2 year kind of time span if you're coming from another degree. If you don't have a degree and you're in high school and you're thinking of going into nutrition after you graduate high school, then you're starting fresh and you're looking at a 4 year degree. Unless you want to take classes every summer, then you may be able to cut down a semester and just finish quicker. But generally, if you follow, you know, the template, you know, the class schedule, it will take you 4 years for a Bachelor's of Science. Be prepared to take a lot of chemistry, a lot of science. I mean, I took biochem, organic chemistry, what else? Just general chemistry. Then you're going to take anatomy. I took anatomy 1 and 2, physiology. What else? Just like very science specific classes. And then you're going to have your nutrition classes, from the basic one, nutrition 101. And then you're going to have medical nutrition therapy. You're going to have all these very nutrition related classes, which those are honestly the fun ones, but you do typically need to get through your science first in order to understand all the chemistry and all the science, because when you study nutrition is science. It's going to be very chemistry based, so you do need to get through your biology and all the chemistry so that you can understand the food part of it, the nutrition part of it. So typically they make you actually take those classes, the science classes, before you even go into nutrition. So for me, I felt very frustrated the first year, even second year, because all I was doing was taking classes other than nutrition. I'm like, when am I going to actually take nutrition? And that's going to be more your third and fourth year, at least for me it was. There are a ton of places that advertise nutrition degrees, but if they're not a true accredited, and they call it didactic program, if they're not one of those didactic programs, you won't be able to proceed and become a registered dietitian. And I will get into that and you will understand the process a little bit better. You're gonna want to go on the Academy of Nutrition and Dietetics website, which is also called eat.org, but I'll have all the links. And on that specific link that I left you, there is a specific place where you can look at schools that are accredited and, you know, are the legit thing. So you just search by state or just in general in America. So after you have your list of schools and you've made your choice, you've applied to that school that has a didactic program and you've been enrolled and you're in, it's a little bit more than just worrying about your bachelor. The difference between a nutrition degree is that many degrees, once you're in them, you're like, you know, your GPA doesn't count that much. You just want to get through it, at least, you know, pass with a C and just finish, and you will have your diploma and you will have your own bachelor's. With nutrition is a little bit differently because all your grades and your GPA is going to count when you need to apply for an internship. Also, while you're doing your degree, you want to make sure that you're getting some sort of experience in the field. Even if it's volunteering, non-paid, you need to get yourself experience, which is very difficult when you're doing this type of degree because it's already so time consuming and it's so difficult. Then on top of classes, you still need to go and give some of your, I mean, if you can find a paid experience, that's awesome, but most likely you're gonna have to do it some kind of volunteering opportunity, like at food banks, at a hospital, at a clinic, and they look at general GPA and then they look at specific science GPA. They break it down and they also want to see that you have experience. You've been doing something towards your degree other than just school. So basically, once you're done your degree and you've done everything you can, just keep in mind that nutrition, at least in America, is very competitive. Not everyone will get an internship right off of school. I've heard people that it takes them 3 years, three times to get an internship, and it's very competitive. The one thing I have to say, if you're flexible and you can go anywhere in the country, that's going to open some opportunities for you because you can just, it gives you so much more, you know, like chances of getting an internship. In my case, I needed to stay here. I mean, I had my house, you know, my mortgage, all that. I couldn't leave. So I was very limited to the internships around my house or around where I live, like my state. So that made it a little bit more difficult. Somehow I got, you know, lucky, or I mean, because it is kind of like a luck system the way it works. It's a, you know, computerized system that matches you. You go for interviews, which are very, very hard. I mean, that week of my interviews, I was so drained. But I did a lot of legwork. I mean, like I said, throughout my degree, I volunteered with a food company at a hospital. I got some clinical experience. I got some food experience. So by the time I went to the specific internship that I wanted, number one, it's hard to get an interview, but once you get it, thank yourself. Once you get the interview, that person actually, the director, already knew me from like knowing that I had volunteered with the company. They knew me just from references, from other interns. So yeah, I mean, you really need to do some work while you're in your degree. So then you're going to apply for your internship, and the application process is long. You need to write a personal letter just talking about you, explaining why you deserve the internship, why you want to do nutrition. I wrote like 5 letters and had my director in school review it. I did that over Christmas break. Then you have to just make sure you have all the papers, all the right documentation to apply. And I'll leave all the information down below because, I mean, if I talked in every detail about everything, it would take a long time. But if you go to these sites, you will have all the information you need, but it will take you some time looking at it because it's intense, it's a lot. But basically, after you apply, you are going to get interviews, hopefully. The matching process, I think, they reveal who got an internship on April 1st of every year. So you do interviews before that, and then on April 1st, the computer system will tell you, and it's nationally. And then I was very fortunate to get my very first choice. Let me just give you some tips as far as internships. The way I scheduled my interviews, I started out with my third choice so that I felt like first day I'm gonna be nervous, so let's just put my third choice because I'm probably not gonna be like my best. Second day, I scheduled my second choice, so I figured I would be a little bit better and a little bit more prepared. And then third day was my first choice, the internship I really, really wanted. So I thought by then, by third day, I was a pro at interviews. So maybe that helped. I felt like by the third day, the interview was just like a conversation, very easy for me. So I did get my very first choice. Be prepared financially. It's like your fifth year of school, even though it's not related to your own school. You have to get it on your own. You're not gonna be paying school tuition. You pay a fee, but it's, you know, it's not like real tuition. Be prepared financially. Internships are expensive. They go anywhere from $10,000 to $20,000 for 1 year. So it's that the fee that you have to pay, which is expensive, and then it's a whole year that you're working as a dietitian for free. So not only are you giving your time, you're also paying them. So basically, it's a whole year. You have to complete 1,200 hours of supervised practice, and that just you do a bunch of rotations. You go, depending on your internship, mine was very clinical. So your internship is going to be a very intense year, but you're going to be learning so much. You're going to be gaining so much experience. I feel like when you start your internship and you're like, you know, just thrown into a hospital or into a clinic, you're going to feel like, oh my gosh, after 4 years of school, you know all the theories and all the science, but you feel like you don't know it because you haven't had the chance to apply it. Then once you do the internship and you're pretty much practicing as a dietitian, the only difference is that, you know, your preceptor is teaching you, is correcting you, and has co-signed legally your notes, but you learn so much and you finally have a chance to use all the knowledge you've acquired for 4 years. Also with internships, there's something called coordinated programs, which is you can do the internship, but you can also do a master's all at once. And those typically last 2 years. So those are gonna be even harder because you're doing the internship plus a master's. But I think they'll probably work out better in the long run because you do pay more. They're gonna be a lot more expensive because you're paying for a master's. But after you're done, not only do you have your internship, but you also have your master's. After you're done your internship and your full year of experience and a lot of learning, you are not done. Now you have your bachelor's, and you have your diploma from your internship, and this is your fifth year if you were able to pass every single class and you're on time. But now you have to study for the registration exam, which is a national exam, which is a combination of everything you've learned through your internship, through your bachelor's, and yeah, for the past 5 years in your life. So you have to study a lot, and I studied for around, I would say, a month and a half. And I do recommend that you purchase the Jean Inman study tool, and I will leave the link for that. That's all I've used. Many people in my internship, that's all they use, and it's expensive, but it works. I mean, we've all, no one in our internship, I don't think anyone failed. We all passed the first time. She does live classes. I didn't participate in those, but her pack comes with CDs and with a binder. The binder has like the oral part of it, like textbook-like, and then the CD, you can listen to it along. What I did was I listened to it when I was driving, you know, just to repeat, and I listened to it while I was reading, and she'll say things like note. When she says things like note, you know that's important, so I would highlight it and like just put a star next to that when I was reading. Then you have practice tests, practice quizzes that you can do. She gives you a lot of practice quizzes, and those are very important. There are questions that are even the same. When I took the exam, there were similar questions, so that was very helpful. If you pass the quizzes and you take them over and over, and after you fail her paper quizzes, you just go back and see which areas you need to review. And I've listened to those CDs over and over, and it will make you fall asleep, but they're worth it. But I recommend that you schedule your test, because if you have a date scheduled, it's gonna make you study daily. And what I did was I scheduled it and I counted back how much I needed to study every single day in order to be prepared by that date. And in my case, what happened was that the night before or 2 days prior, I felt like, okay, I'm still not prepared for that date, and I rescheduled it. But then again, it still made me study all the way up until that date. Then I rescheduled it, and then I kind of like said, okay, now I have X amount of time until the next date, and this is what I need to study. And I was actually the second person in my internship to pass. I took the test very very early on, I think only a month and a half after I graduated my internship, I felt it was intense. It was a 3-hour test. It was super intense, but I don't think it was that difficult. If you're very prepared, it's not that difficult. I know I've talked to other dietitians that found it very difficult. I feel like if you passed biochem, biology, anatomy, and you have your degree, it's not gonna be as hard. It's really not. It's just a lot of information to memorize. Also, adding to the expense, be prepared to pay, I think it's $250 for the RD exam. So after you pass, and I forgot to actually mention, you can't, after you're done your internship, you can't just go ahead and register. You need to wait for a paper, like an authorization code. I'm actually like not remembering the right term, but you have to wait until you get some kind of paper to register. And that's all your internship director. They submit all your papers once you graduate the internship. And then once they get that, you know, it gets processed and you will receive the paper you need to register for the exam. So after you take your exam and you've passed, it will say congratulations, you became a registered dietitian. You will, in a couple of weeks, receive your card, but you would think, okay, now I have my bachelor's, I have the internship, and I have passed the registration exam. I'm done. No, you're not. You're really not done, because in order to maintain your registration status, you need to do 75 educational credits every 5 years, just to keep your license. Every year, though, you have to renew, but that's just, they send you a bill, you pay the fee, and they give you a card. But every 5 years, in order to keep your status, you have to show that you've done continued educations. And I have a website where you can look up they call it the CEUs. You have ones that you pay, ones that are free. I feel like it hasn't been that difficult. I'll like watch a lot of webinars, and they really help you keep educated about science, because science changes, you know, new studies come out. So you need to be on top of the new studies out there. So it just makes you be on top. Some states in America do have state licensing. So my state unfortunately has, when I was working 2 hours away, not 2 hours away, 20 minutes away over the board, the other state didn't have it. But right now where I work, I need to keep a state licensing. So every 2 years I need to have 30 CEUs, I think, yes. However, those 30 count towards the national ones, but if the timing is off, you have to make sure. There might be a couple that don't count because of how everything renews. It's kind of confusing. So that's pretty much it. In sum, you do your bachelor's in science and nutrition, then you do the internship, then you take the RD exam, and then to maintain your registration status, you need to do 75 CEUs per 5 years, and also look out for your state CEUs that you need to do to maintain that licensing, because a job will not take you if you're not a registered dietitian, and if your state requires legislation for nutrition, you need to be licensed in that. As far as jobs that you can do when you become a registered dietitian, it kind of varies, and it's a very much growing field. You're starting to see more jobs in places where you didn't see them, but to start off with the ones that have been going on for years, you have the hospital ones. Right now I work in clinical, I work at a hospital, and basically there's no way by law you have to have registered dietitians in hospitals. They really can't function without that, because you need to do artificial feeding when someone is intubated, or you know, they can't breathe, they can't eat, so you need to do enteral, which is tube feeding, you need to do parenteral. All these terms will sound kind of weird to you if you're not in the field, but a lot of people think about nutrition and they think it's just about weight loss. I honestly don't do any of weight loss in the hospital. I do mostly survival, getting people to be healthy, to survive, by, you know, based on a specific disease, based on their labs. It's just a lot more clinical. If you're into what we call more outpatient, which is weight loss, just living healthier, you can open your own practice, or you can work for someone that has your own practice. A lot of primary care physicians are now having dietitians, which is very exciting. You can be a school dietitian, in which you just do the school lunches and work with kids and pediatrics. Which brings me to even part of clinical, you'll have different areas. You'll have pediatrics, you'll have geriatrics. You'll have all these areas that you can pick. Maybe you like to work with older people, maybe you like to work with younger, you know, people, younger kids, pediatrics. So other things that are growing are supermarkets are starting to have dietitians to do tours. If you're shopping and you have a specific disease and you know you can't eat a specific food, you can just ask a supermarket dietitian to give you a tour to help you out with your groceries. So there was a lady that works with me. She's a dietitian at the hospital and she also teaches nutrition at a university at night. So there's a lot to do. It's very exciting. I would say it's a very rewarding job. I feel like I can make a difference daily. If you want to, I can share if you want to, you know, my typical day at work. I do a lot of rounds with doctors and nurses. We talk about the critical care of a patient. It's just very exciting. I feel like daily I make a difference. You see these vulnerable people at the hospital, you know, just suffering, and they're there, and they may make it, they may not make it, and it just makes me feel so good that not only is it my job, it's what pays my bills, but it's also something that I'm doing out of my heart, and I'm helping a human being. So it's very rewarding. I really hope you found this video helpful. There's a lot of research that you need to do, so I just try to give you a broad idea. I wish I would have found videos like this when I was, you know, looking at everything, because everything sounded just so overwhelming. I like kept feeling overwhelmed, but like I was like, what do you mean? I need an internship? I only found out that I needed an internship 2 years into my degree, which was very surprising. I thought I was going to be done after my bachelor's. So it's very frustrating. Then you know you have your internship and DRD exam. So I hope I gave you a good broad idea. Check all the links down below. These are places that I had to check myself when I was planning everything and trying to find all the information. So check out for that. And if you have other questions, comment down below and I will try to answer them as much as I can. I really want to help you. I know it's a lot of information and it's not like an easy field to get into. It's very competitive, but I wish you all the luck. If this is something you really love, don't give up, believe in yourself. And yeah, so thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed the video and found it helpful, and I will talk to you in my next video. Bye guys.